Hello and greetings from Iceland. I had it planned to use this update to dig deeper than I did yesterday, and I will still try to do so, but as I was finishing my notes for this video, the biggest earthquake so far struck or magnitude 5.4 as it looks now. So it's all over the media here in Iceland right now, and I'm linking to a video where you can see it from through different webcams, and I'm sure we will get more such videos in the next days. But the first version of this video was going to be all about the magma dike that has been confirmed around here or between Mount Keilir and where the eruption in 2021 took place in Geldingadalir. The magma is moving closer to the surface. It can be seen through the 3000 earthquakes since yesterday, but the large one that just struck 2 hours ago is totally off the charts. And due to summer vacations, most likely or something like that, it has been hard to get some data about it. So the media was feeding us with wrong information for an hour. But the thing is that the earthquakes don't take summer vacations. And we had to learn it the hard way today. But anyhow, what do we know? The location is just around here, just by the town Grindavík. And it's categorized as a trigger earthquake or a sign of stress release due to magma moving around. But not in the areas where they are measured, however. And as you look at the larger picture, or earthquakes for the past 6 hours, we see them also east from the epicenter. And this has, according to experts, to do with the dike that's in the forming, or just around here. And this was so close by the town, Grindavík, that damages have been reported already. And this is by far the worst earthquake to hit the town for the past 2 years. So let's swap to drone view and see what I've got there. And we find the epicenter of the earthquake just around here, and the depth was around 1.9 kilometers. And it occurred to me, are we looking at potential eruption just by town? But there was a magma intrusion teasing them just weeks ago, and that problem is still present, or just around here from the map, or where the land uplift started 2 years ago. So is there a dike between the area around the town and Geldingadalir? But this is getting that serious now that I'm sure that we will get some better answers in the next days. But let's move over what we have learned since yesterday. Last night, I was sure that I was about to witness a new Geldingadalir eruption as I could see the heat coming up from the crater. So I found myself glued to the screen for a while. But then, knowing the statistics, it's only 1 out of every 10 magma intrusions that make it all the way. So as we moved into Sunday, things had cooled down a bit, but not that much though. And it bugged me a bit this morning that we didn't get as much data about the earthquakes or confirmed the depth and such, because it's only then when they appear on the second webpage where you can make a time lapse, like I did last year. And I'm going to play it again now and notice that we have the dike that fed the 2021 eruption here. And the earthquakes take place just above it now in the middle. And as the time-lapse goes on, it looks as the peninsula is being fed from east to west, which is logical because the landmass on the peninsula gets thinner as we move west, less sealed volcanoes and smaller. The interval between frames is 24 hours in this case, but it's possible to use as little as 1 minute, but very time-consuming. But this way of looking at earthquakes can be quite exciting, so I would like to make a new playback of the magma dike that we are seeing now. But then, again, we have to wait for some days until the data has been corrected manually. But it is believed that the magma can be at as little as 2 kilometers depth, and even if the earthquake swarm would come to an end now, it might just make things more complicated, like last year. But it was after an earthquake swarm came to an end that one of our experts said, "This is nothing, you can all go home now." But a few hours later, the eruption in Geldingadalir came up. And till this day, it hasn't been explained why the seismometers didn't detect the eruption coming up then. It was the local people in Grindavík that reported that the Christmas lights came early that year. So if we see a sudden drop in seismic activity now, it might not be good news. It might be a better idea to check the webcams, but it's 4 of them up there now. And I'm of course leaving links to all of them. The most popular webcam so far is a crater camera, since it was smoking hot last night. But as for the other cameras, I would be looking at the cameras that are pointing at Mount Keilir, the mountain that you can see in this recent video. But it is official now that the most likely place for an eruption is between the 2021 craters around here and Mount Keilir, or so did one of our experts say today. And I did actually mention that in my video yesterday, And we are back on map.is where we can see all earthquakes for the past 6 hours. And even if the plot isn't completely accurate for the reasons I just mentioned, we see that the dike is heading to the northeast, but not to southwest, like before the eruption last year. And looking at the location and the topography, we see that the most likely place for an eruption now is directly on top of a shield volcano called Þráinsskjöldur, and the lava field around it is called Þráinsskjöldarhraun. And we can call this a half-formed shield volcano, and I did mention it quite often last year, since I was curious to know if the Geldingadalir eruption was just a continuation of that shield volcano project that stopped when it had covered 150 square kilometers, if we include the parts of the lava field that is under sea now, and the volume has estimated to be over 5 cubic kilometers. So the eruption last year was very small. And as we move a bit further east and take a look at Mount Keilir, which sits by the slope of this shield volcano, we can see how large it is. But this clip was shot as a part of a video that I'm making about the volcanoes just by Reykjavík, but I already have lots of good footage from there that I will show you soon. And you will be surprised when you see the landscape around the city, or where we built it. And are we about to see this huge shield volcano wake up again? It's hard to say. A volcanologist said just after the earthquakes today that Mother Earth had something big going on this time, and I believe him. So I am heading south to cover this one there, but I'm in Akureyri, up north now. But I have another photo project in the south that I can use to justify the trip. But we might be moving into some major events, maybe even in the next days. So I might have to change my ways or how I make my videos for a while, since it's impossible for me to deliver scripted videos on the road. So I might even try live broadcast or whatever works. But at least I can promise you that you will get extra good footage and extra good maps all the way through whatever is about to hit us here in Iceland this time. But we remain hopeful. Eruptions on the peninsula are not that large usually, and compared to many of our volcanic systems, they are very easy to deal with. But the proximity to the fishery town Grindavík and our capital Reykjavík is of course what worries us the most. And I will cover all that for the next weeks. And with that, I am sending you best regards from the volcano island, Iceland.